Hello and welcome to this seventh tutorial video on how to make a button jointed memory bear. I've used exactly the same technique to fill the legs and the arms as I did on the body. In the legs I used about 2 tablespoons of plastic pellets, which just about filled the feet. In the arms I used 1 tablespoon, which just about filled to the top of the paws, and then I filled with polyfiber stuffing and sewed up with ladder stitch. Now with all of that done, we're ready to button joint the arms and legs onto our bear. Use about 60 centimetres of cotton pearl or embroidery thread and your long doll needle. And the first thing you need to do is identify the darts that come down from the top of the body there. And we're going to position the arms over the top. Now you may have marked the dot on the outside where your arms are going to be positioned, but a rule of thumb is the joint, the button joint, and therefore your doll needle is going to go through this position where the dart ends. I'm going to pin this in place by putting a normal bobblehead pin through the top of the arm, and then when I'm happy with that, one at the bottom, and the arm should reach just about down to the center seam, just a centimeter or two off the center seam there, and just pin that in place. Mind your thumb here. There we go. And we're going to do the same with the arm from the opposite side. Make sure your paw pads are pointing in. Match up your positioning again. That's where your pattern's going to come in handy on your fabric. And then when you're happy that you've got that right, pin that second arm into position. Just a bobble-headed pin through the top and one through the bottom will do at this point. It's going to make it a lot easier for you to button joint with these held in place. There we go. I've got nice quality pins so they don't bend too easily. Okay, let's button joint. With your long doll needle with your thread attached, go in through the armpit at the point that you marked, or at the bottom of your dart if you haven't marked. Go all the way through the body, through the arm, and that's going to be, this button's going to be quite central at the top of the arm, a nice even gap around it, through the first hole of the button. Leave enough of the thread hanging here so that you can tie it. Okay, not too much because we're going to have to go through a few times. So now we're going to go through the other hole of the button, and quite close to the original point that we came out, all the way through and out at about the same position on the opposite arm. So the button, once it's in position, is going to have a nice even amount of arm all the way around it. It's going to be sitting quite nice and centrally on the top of the arm. Pull that through. Make sure your tail's still hanging so you haven't lost that inside the body. Okay. Then we're going to add the other button, making sure that if there is a right and a wrong side, your wrong side is obviously against the bear's body. Through the arm, through the body, and with a little bit of jiggling out through the other button. Now if you've got 4 holes in your button, start going through the opposite 2. I've only got 2 holes, so I'm going back in and out through the same 2 holes. Pull that a little tight there. Pull the thread all the way through. And again, I'm still checking that I've got my tail hanging there so I can knot it. Through the second hole again, all the way through the body, all the way out through the arm. So I've got 2 stitches on that side and I'm just creating the last of my 2 stitches on this side. So back in through there and out at the back of the arm at the same position that my thread's gone through, and pull it through to the back. So I've now got both ends of my thread hanging down, and I can knot these. I'm going to pull it nice and tight, make sure everything's securely in, and tie a double knot, an extra third knot for security. I'm left with one short and one long thread. I'm going to pop the needle back in at the same position that I've come out, and I'm going to lose this thread in the body in the same way that we've done with the head and with the eyes. Pull it through, doesn't really matter where you come out, pull it tight and then snip. And if you ever do end up with a short thread like this, all you've got to do is thread your needle through first, bring the eye of the needle close to your thread, and then you can pass your thread through the eye of the needle. So it doesn't matter if you've got a short piece of thread, you can still use a long doll needle to lose the end inside. And then just pull it through the body, pull that end tight again. I've got a little thread hanging there. I can do exactly the same there with that little one that's come through. Pass my doll needle through, pass that last little bit through the eye of the needle, and then pull it through the body and snip it off. There we go, that's the arms jointed. We can remove the pins at top and bottom, and there he is, movable button jointed arms. Lovely. Those buttons work really well on him. Now let's have a go at the legs. We're going to use exactly the same technique. And you've got a dart again here, so that's another nice handy positioning point. Just in the same way, sort of a line going down the body. We want them to be quite central. And that button again fitting nicely in the middle of the top of the thigh there. I want to make sure the bottom of that leg is level with the body so that he sits nicely. So I'm going to just pop it into position again, back of the leg, bottom of the leg level with the body, and just rotate it to be sure that I've got the positioning. You're going to pin this into position using bobblehead pins again. Go. That dart there gives us a nice line to work from. There are positioning marks on your pattern. That pins across there, so I can pin this in the same position using the pattern on the fabric as a guide. Once we're happy that that positioning is good, that button's going to fit on the outside there. So again, a long length of thread, that's sitting there. Look at where it would have come through, go through the body at that position, out through the opposite side, through the line of that dart, through the top of the leg. Try not to angle your needle, try and keep it in a straight line going through the leg. And then when it comes out again, leave a tail hanging for knotting. Pop your button on there. And we're going to use exactly the same technique. Through the leg, through the body, keeping our needle going in close to where our thread's already gone through, all the way through. Come out at the same position on the leg. Use your pattern if you have pattern to work out where that is. Once you've pulled that through, pop your other button on. Close to the original thread, all the way through leg, body, and then opposite leg. I'm just making sure as I come out through here that this button hasn't twisted, the threads aren't twisted, and then the needle can go through there. If it gets too twisted, then it's harder to pull it tight. Make sure the tail's still hanging for me to knot it. Pull the needle through, getting a little tangled with the thread here, pull it nice and tight, that's it, and then back through. All the way to the opposite side. Coming out at the same position as the previous threads. And then once we've done that one, we're going to pass through to that joint between the leg and the body again. Coming out where the threads are at the back. There we go. Making sure it's nice and tight. And then tying our knot. One. Two, three for luck, and then lose my threads inside, pull that tight, very careful at this point not to snip your fabric, that would be just a disaster when you're this close to completing. And then pass the thread into the doll needle eye, back in through the same position as the threads, out further up the body, pull it tight and snip. It pins out, and let's look at his positioning of his arms and legs. That's lovely. He's done. I'm really pleased with him, our little button jointed memory bear. He's gorgeous.
That concludes our tutorial video. I hope it's been helpful. If it has, please subscribe to the channel, give us some feedback and a like. There are more videos coming soon.